Hi everybody, good evening. So, before we get into Om, I want to just tell you how really innovative and how amazing our culture was, our traditions were in India a few thousand years ago. You know, Himanshu and Arvindji, they talked about innovation and doing stuff with small things. Well, let's start with that. Everybody heard of the Varaha Avatar? No? Yes? He's the boar, he comes and lifts the earth out of the roaring seas. But just notice the shape of the earth. It's round. A few thousand years ago, we knew that the earth was round. Amazing, huh? Yes? And we call geography Bhugol. Huh? Meaning about something which is round. It is not Bhutatte, which means something which is flat. It is Bhugol. Yes? And we call the earth itself Jagat. Jagat means Jiski Gati Hai, means that which moves. So we knew that the earth moved. We knew that it was not stationary. And this was thousands of years ago. Yes? Okay. Let's go into space. There is this star called Antares. Okay? It is called Antares like Ares because Ares is red. It's like Mars. It's a red star. And our ancients, it's the 15th brightest object in the sky. And our ancients amazingly or strangely called it Jyeshtha. Yeah? Jyeshtha means oldest, biggest, eldest. Yes? Now, why would you call the 15th brightest object? It's not the brightest, meaning, it is not obvious that it should be called Jyeshtha. Turns out, it is 40,000 times bigger than our sun. In fact, it is one of the biggest known objects to man. It is the hugest, one of the hugest objects that we know of. Yeah, this star called Antares, which our ancients called Jyeshtha. Yes, the next one is really cool. Ursa Major, I think I deserve a better clap than that. Okay. The next one, Ursa Major, the Big Bear. Everybody has heard of it, at least if you've not seen it in today's pollution, we can hardly see any stars. But Ursa Major constellation, a lot of those things are named, but I am interested in that particular star there. Turns out it's not a star, it's a twin star. And our ancients call that star Arundhati and Vasishtha. And in ancient India, there was a tradition, actually even today in South India, there is a tradition that when you get married, on the first night, you should go out with your husband and see the star. See this particular star, this star system. Now, that's a very strange thing to do, why go out and see that particular star? Well, most star systems, most twin star systems are such that one is stationary and the other rotates around it. Yes, like that. Now, this is definitely not how a husband and wife should be, just the husband in the middle and the wife around, or the wife in the middle and the husband around. Yes? How does Arundhati and Vasishtha rotate? Like that. Now, just imagine, that dot in the sky, they figured out it was a twin star system. They also figured out that it rotates like that. Amazing. Yes? Okay, let's come down to Earth. Yes? Rust-proof iron. Did you know? We have at least 100 pillars in India made thousands of years ago, which are rust-proof. That one in Delhi, most people know. You can't see it too well, but it's, you can see that little thing around the blue. Yeah? It's rust-proof. Delhi pollution has not managed to do anything to it. Yes? The other one in Kollur, it's about 10-11 meters high and 750 centimeters of rain, 6 to 8 months a year. Rust proof for the past 2,500 years. Yes? Okay, now here is a nice shloka which says, Krishna, you are great. Okay, as most shlokas do. Unless they are written by, the other side. Now, it's a nice shloka, but there is this thing called Katapayadi Sankhya. It's a protocol where they assign particular numbers to particular alphabets. Yeah? So, Katapaya is 1 and so on. And you know what that becomes? it becomes the value of pi correct to 30 decimal places. Yeah, amazing, no? Next. Okay, we are in Goa, right? And there is this place called Vasco da Gama. Yes? Heard of it? You know, it is named after this guy called Vasco da Gama who came and supposedly discovered Goa. Yes? Okay, what most people don't know is Vasco da Gama, when he left Europe, he took the biggest ship that was available, and then very close to the land, close to the shore, he went all the way to the southern tip of Africa. After which, he met this Gujarati trader called Kanha, who had 5 ships which were 10 times bigger than the biggest ship available in Europe at that point. And Kanha actually escorted Vasco da Gama to Goa. Yes? This fact was found in Vasco da Gama's diary, personal diary, which is right now in Lisbon. Okay? So maybe we should rename Vasco da Gama to Kanha. What do you say? Yes? I like to think maybe he was Kanha Patel, but it doesn't say that he was Patel or not, but it sounds like a Patel to me. Yes? You know, the reason why we had this kind of innovation, the reason why we had this kind of amazing technology, yes? In fact, I think India, ancient India would have been tech paradise, you know, technology, entertainment and design all were there. Yes? So, it was because all our scientists were saints. Everybody used to do pranayam, everybody used to do yoga, everybody used to meditate. And so, they were never limited by physical instruments. They did not need a telescope or a microscope. They could just close their eyes and go by themselves where they wanted to. Yes? And the basis of yoga is Om. Yeah? Patanjali, who wrote the Yoga Sutras out, does not sign them as Patanjali. He signs them as Om. Okay? And since today it is about innovation, I thought we should look at an innovative way of looking at Om. Yes? Yes. Okay, yes. Can we have the audience lights on, please? So, yeah, this is the cool part. So, I want you all to sit relaxed, comfortably. Alright? We are going to experience Om. Alright? Like, I don't think most of you have experienced it this way. So, Om is basically 3 syllables. A, U and Ma. Okay? Now, we are going to chant them out. Okay? First, we are going to say A 3 times. Okay? And when you say A, I want you to feel on your body, you might feel some sensation. I want you to tell me where it is. Okay? So you close your eyes and we are going to chant A out 3 times. Okay? Now it's going to be done like this. You're going to take a deep breath in and you're going to go A like that. The pitch is low. Okay? Don't go A, not like that. Okay? It's A. Alright? 3 times. Okay? Let's close our eyes. Take a deep breath in. Once more. Once more. Sensation. Somewhere here in this region, some of you might have felt it on the chest, but it was like going down like that. Some of you might have felt it on the stomach. Yes? Very good. Now we do U. Okay? Again, we'll chant the U and then you tell me where you feel it. Cool? Eyes closed. Everybody, nice and loud. Ooh. Now where was it? This area? This was much more obvious, right? Yes, this area. Now we do the M with the mouth closed. So it's alright? Eyes closed. This is really nice. You'll like it. Nice and loud. Okay? Breathe in. And open your eyes. Where was this one? Up. Yes? Unmistakable? Up here? Yes? Okay, confirmatory test. One hand on your stomach, one hand on your chest. Sit comfortably, okay? Now we'll chant the ah out, you, and you feel it, okay? Keep your eyes open. Breathe in. Ah. Can you feel something here? Put your hand on your head. You will feel nothing here. It's mainly somewhere here. Okay, now do the oo. Ooh. See how the sound has moved up? Ooh. Very little bit on your head. Check your head. Ooh. Now do the ma. See the head. Mm. Can you feel? Just feel the cheeks. Mm. Very, not, almost nothing here and here. Amazing? Yes? Yes? So the ah, oo and ma, they vibrate at different parts of your body. And when you put them together, you get om. And so when you chant om, it kind of takes the energy up like that. Okay? Let's do that now. Okay? I want you to really feel it. Okay? Just observe what's happening as you're chanting the om. Three times. Eyes closed. Feels nice? Yes? Yes. Like something is settled down? Interesting, no? Yeah? Now, there are many, many interpretations of Om, and one of my favorite ones is the A comes from Brahma. Now, who is Brahma? The creator, right? And do you notice all the creation happens here? The baby is born here, the food is digested here, energy is created here. The U comes from Vishnu. Who is Vishnu? The preserver. This is your life support organs. It preserves life. And the M is Maheshwara. Who is Maheshwara? He's the transformer, not the destroyer. Yeah? He transforms from one. And that's what you do here, isn't it? You think and you transform. You bring new things out. Right? Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. A, U, Ma, Om. Yeah? No, it's nice. Yeah, okay, clap, clap. And it's nice to know this. It's really nice to know this. But is there some practical application of this here to us? Yes, there is. Okay? You know, there are these three energies are there in all of us. Some of us are intensely creative, very, very creative people. Yes? You have high Brahma energy. Some of us don't like creation, but we can preserve. You build me a system, I will run it for you. Vishnu. And some of us are the troubleshooters. Yes? We have needed a lot of them on this event, isn't it? Yes. But have you noticed, whenever something has gone wrong, we always call for that one person. Usko sab pata hai. He knows everything. He will fix it. Right? Yes? So depending on your energy, if you choose your career, if you choose what you want to do in your life, you will be very happy doing it and they will actually pay you for it. Right? Yes? So, Om can help you choose a career. Acha, if you are managing a team, if you can figure out what the energies of your team members are and give them jobs accordingly, they will love you. They will give their life for you. Yes? Have you noticed that certain teachers, certain bosses, they can bring out the best from us? Yes? We keep thinking about them. Right? This is because consciously or unconsciously, they have figured out what your energy is and they have managed to bring that up in you. And so you enjoy working with them. Okay? Finally, raising children. Have you noticed that young children, usually young, by young I mean 3-4 years old, they usually exhibit one of these three very clearly. Like there is one who will be very, very creative. Like Arvindji. Yeah? Where he will take 3-4 things, put them together and say, new thing. Yes? This is high Brahma. Okay. And then there will be that second kid who is the parent's dream. No, he doesn't really play with anything, he just arranges everything. Yes? Complete, you know, the parents will be, my child is an angel. Yes? And of course there's a third crackpot who goes around with a hammer, you know, wanting to find out what's inside, right? Okay. Now children will exhibit these energies. Yes? As an older brother or sister or as a parent, if you can give them toys, games, books, which bring out the other energies, then by the time they are 16 or 17, they are equally adept at all three. And this is such a blessing in life. You know, if you check out the heads of any successful corporations, which means governments are out. you will find that the person on the top exhibits all three energies perfectly. He is brilliant at creation, bringing out new things. He is fantastic at preservation. And he is ruthless when it comes to cutting down things which don't make profit. Right? Yes? So Om can teach you how to choose your career. Om can teach you how to manage a team. And Om can teach you how to run a business. Yes? Interesting, huh? Yes? So, a lot of this talk is inspired by my guru, my Guruji, His Holiness Sri Sri Ravi Shankarji, the founder of the Art of Living. Yeah? And a little bit of the earlier part was inspired by this amazing person called Dr. D.K. Hari and his wife Hema Hari, who run this thing called Bharat Gyan. Yes? All the things that I showed you in the beginning, it comes from Bharat Gyan. They have done extensive super research about what ancient India was. And you can just check out their website as well. Okay? Thank you very much. Jai Guru.
Baba. So I'm just actually very curious about what took you from, and we sort of covered this yesterday, but I don't think everybody knows. What took you from maths? Spirituality.
You know, I almost all of you have heard of that book, 5 Point Someone. Yeah. Well, I was 4 Point Someone. Okay, and you know, Arvindji was just asking me. So you did a 2-year MS from IIT Bombay. I said yes, but it took me 3 years. Yeah. So while I was still studying. My seniors who would graduate would say, you know, Baba, you enjoy yourself over here because after that life is really bad. And I was getting royally, you know, can you use the word? Screwed. While I was still there studying and I was thinking, my God, you know, if this is pleasure, what's waiting for me there? You know? And at that time, I had the good fortune of being bulldozed into an Art of Living course. You know, the phone conversation went like this. Hey, sweetheart, what are you doing today evening and for the next 4 days? I said, well, nothing much. So you come for this course. I said, what's the course about? She said, it's about breathing. I said, breathing is boring. She said, shut up and come, otherwise I'll kill you. Very fat friend of mine. I said, all right, how much does it cost? So she said, in Hindi, tere ko kya farak padta hai, tera baap banne wala hai. I said, right, so talk to the father, I will be there. So I went for the course, I loved it. It changed a lot of things. And then, it was then that I saw Guruji, I met Guruji. And here was this man who was 5 foot nothing in height. And he was supremely happy. Really, really happy. And then there was a choice. Do I follow my batchmates into a proven way of getting... or do I follow this 5 foot nothing person who is so happy? And so it was very easy. Yes? So when people ask me, what made you go from maths to meditation? You are from IIT? I said, yeah, it is because I am from IIT and because I studied maths and because I am intelligent that I went there.
So finally, one of the questions I think always is asked is, you know, science and spirituality, they're supposed to be at loggerheads with each other. Do you agree? Do you disagree?
No.
Can you explain sort of how they relate to each other?
You know, like I said, in India, all our scientists were saints. They were spiritual and therefore they were scientists. And you know, there is a very little known quote by a person called Albert Einstein. Heard of him? He says, I draw my inspiration from this book in India called the Bhagavad Gita. Science and spirituality are not separate. They are the same thing. They are the, you know, science is about the outside, spirituality is about the inside. And without knowing both, you are not complete.
And before you close, I just want to ask, you have to tell young people how to find their happiness, their passion, their calling, outside of chanting Om. What would you say?
You know, I was asked, when I went for my US visa, describe in one sentence, what is the Art of Living? It's a 6-day course, it's, you know, all that. And I was supposed to say it in one sentence, and she had that stamp, you know. So I looked at her directly in her eyes and said, Art of Living is so that you can get up on Monday morning and smile. And she said, no kidding. And I said, no, I mean it. She said, boy, we need it in America. And she gave me a 10-year visa instead of a 6-month.
Thank you so much.